In this video, you are going to learn what sensitivity and specificity are and why those statistical values are important for you as a physio. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Sensitivity and specificity both influence how valid, or in other words, how accurate a clinical test is. Validity means to what degree a test measures what it claims to measure. So, for example, a valid test for your body weight would be a scale. There are a lot of different special tests in the literature to test for the same condition. The more accurate a test, the better. The concepts of sensitivity and specificity will tell you which test you should use to confirm or exclude an hypothesis. Let's start with the basics. Let's imagine that we have a couple of people who have a disease, marked in red, and some that don't. With a perfect test, we would be able to discover everyone with the disease and also detect the ones that don't have the disease. The ones that have the disease and that are correctly diagnosed are called true positive, which is abbreviated with TP. The ones that do not have the pathology and that are correctly diagnosed as healthy are called true negative, abbreviated with TN. This test would then be 100% accurate. In real life, however, a perfect test does not exist, and we will have patients that are diagnosed with the disease but that are actually healthy, called false positive. So for example, this one would be false positive. And at the same time, you will have patients with the disease, but your test could not detect them and was negative. They are called false negative, abbreviated with FN. Now let's look at a test that is 100% sensitive. Sensitivity is the ability to detect something. Imagine an alarm that you have installed at home and that goes off with the tiniest movement. So a 100% sensitive test is a test that can detect all people that have the disease, so no single person that has the disease is missed. You can imagine that you would want to have a highly sensitive test when you are testing for potentially fatal diseases like cancer, because missing an ill person could potentially lead to the person's death. All the persons that tested negative can be sent home because they definitely do not have the disease. So with a 100% sensitive test, abbreviated as SN, we do not have any false negatives. Therefore, if they have a negative test result, we can be 100% sure that they do not have the disease and we can rule them out. Snout, like in the snout of an animal in this example here, is the mnemonic that you should remember. Maybe you have already discovered the problem in the example from before. We have two people who were diagnosed as positive, but who are actually healthy. If we modify our example a bit and we now say that, for example, everyone has a positive test outcome, we still have a test that is 100% sensitive. The problem now is that a lot of them are falsely diagnosed positive, and therefore our test accuracy will suffer. For this reason, we need a test that is more specific. So now let's look at a test that is 100% specific. You have to imagine specificity as the extent to which a positive test result really represents the condition or disease of interest and not some other condition mistaken for it. In this case, when a test is positive, you can be 100% sure that this person has the disease. However, like you can see in this example here, a specific test can miss people that have the disease. So they are going to be sent home with a false negative result. In a 100% specific test, there are no false positives. So if a patient has a positive test result, you can be 100% sure that he has the disease. In a highly specific test, abbreviated as SP, you are therefore looking for a positive test result in order to include or confirm your hypothesis. Spin, like in the spin of a basketball, is the mnemonic that you should remember. However, the trade-off of a very specific test is usually that people are falsely diagnosed negative. So you will have a few people that are false negatives and that are sent home although they have the disease. So ideally, you would want a test that has a high sensitivity and a high specificity, but unfortunately, this is rarely the case. Now let's look at an example to make these two concepts of sensitivity and specificity that we have just discussed more concrete. For patients with radicular pain from the lumbosacral area, two commonly used tests to in or exclude this condition are the straight leg raise test and the cross straight leg raise test. According to a review by van der Wind et al. In the year 2010, the SLR has a sensitivity of 92% and a specificity of 28%, and the crossed SLR has a sensitivity of 28% and a specificity of 90%. So which test are you going to use to exclude radicular pain from the lumbosacral region? The answer is the straight leg raise test. Remember our mnemonic snout. We are performing a highly sensitive test in order to look for a negative test outcome to rule out a disease. If this test is negative, we can be pretty sure that our patient does not have lumbosacral radicular pain. To confirm our hypothesis, however, we are using the spin rule. So we are going to do the cross straight leg raise test with a high specificity. Alright, this was our video on sensitivity and specificity. If you are still struggling with these two concepts, it often helps to gain a better understanding if you know how to calculate these two values. You can learn that by a click on a video right next to me. Alright, so I hope sensitivity and specificity have become clearer to you. If this is the case and this video helped you, please give it a like and don't hesitate to send us questions if something is still unclear. Of course, don't forget to subscribe our channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.